Welcome. Welcome. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Sigi. Welcome you from Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton. I want to talk to you the subject called the principle of God against the wicked. The principle of God against the wicked. The Bible says in the book of Psalms 70, verse 2 to 3. The book of Psalms 70, verse 2 to 3. The Bible says, let them be ashamed and confounded that seek after my soul. Let them be turned backward and put to confusion that desire my heart. Let them be turned back, for a reward of their shame that day. Ha ha. You know the principle of God is stand forever and it doesn't change. The principle of God is this, is it doesn't change about the wicked. The wicked people, they plan wicked. They plan bad against you. If you cannot fight, if you cannot stand up to fight, they will fight you and finish you and bring you down. That's why you need to apply the principle of God from the book of Psalm 70, verse 2 and 3, which says that, let them be ashamed and confounded that seek after my soul. Let them be ashamed and confounded. Let them be disgraced and be confounded. Wherever planning evil against you, the principle of God is declaring them, let them be ashamed and confounded. That is the principle of God. God does not change. God has said that he himself will disgrace them and expose them. Himself will confront them. Himself, God himself, is power, is word. It doesn't change. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God does not, the principle of God stands forever and it doesn't change. So the Bible says heaven and earth will pass, but the word of God will never pass. The Bible says in another translation from the book of New Living Translation, the Bible says, may those who try to kill me be humiliated and put to shame. May those who take delight in my trouble to be turned back and disgraced. Let them be horrified by their shame. And for they said, ha ha, we got him now. Let those people, let anybody who's planning to kill you, planning to kill your career, planning to kill your job, planning to kill your children, planning to kill your marriage. The principle of God, it says, let them return against them. Let them be put to confusion. Let their desire be turned back. Look at that. The Bible is declaring a war against wicked personality. The principle of God is the same principle that is against the Goliath, against Pharaoh, against Herod. The principle of God is the principle that killed Herod. When Herod was glorifying himself, the womb of God fall from heaven and the angel of God fall from heaven and smiced Herod, and Herod turned to be eaten by worms. The principle of God that killed Goliath, when Goliath was standing in front of children of Israel, confronting them 40 days, nobody could talk to him. Wherever they see him, people were running backward. The principle of God that killed him is the same principle that will destroy your enemy, that will come against your enemy, that will put down your enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Let them be ashamed and confounded that seek after my soul. Let them be turned backward and put to confusion that desire my heart. let them be turned back for a reward of their shame that say, ha, ha, we got him. We're ever laughing at you. We're ever mocking you. You know God is not a mocker. You cannot mock God and then you go free. The principle of God will kill them. Child of God, don't worry. When the enemy is rising up to start fighting you, fight back. That's why we have prayers which says, send back to the sender. Send back to the sender. If you cannot send back to the sender because you didn't start the war, you didn't start the battle, you didn't start fighting, it is them who have come to fight you. Because they have come to fight you, so you will fight back. There is no way that you cannot fight back. In Job 4, verse 8, the Bible says, even as I have seen, they that plow iniquity and sow wickedness reap the same. Anybody who is planned evil, he will reap the same. In Galatians 6, verse 5 to 7, read it there, you will see what you plan is what you will reap. So everyone who is planning iniquity, sin against you, they do sin against you. They plan wicked and evil to destroy your life. That first sin they do, it will return back to them. They will reap the same thing they are doing to people. That's why the principle of God does not change. What you plan is what you will reap. You see, if you read what Paul is talking about, that you will be shocked. You read Galatians 6, verse 5 to 7. You go there and read it. In the book of Psalms 54, verse 4, the Bible says, he shall reward evil unto my enemies, cut them off in the truth. The Lord will reward evil against your enemies. Enemies that is standing against you, the Lord or himself will cut them off. That is the principle of God. Look at what how David rescued himself. When the enemy, not even David, let us look at example of Daniel. Daniel was arrested and was thrown in the den of lion to eat him up because of the wicked. People were furiously wicked about Daniel and they decided to kill him according to Psalm 70 verse 2 to 3. But what happened? The very people who thrown Daniel to the den of lion, when they were thrown there, the lion grabbed them and eat them up. But the lion did not touch Daniel because Daniel was innocent. When you plan evil against innocent people, against a woman or a woman of God or a man of God, everything you are doing, it will come to your blood, it will come to your head, it will come to your children. In the name of Jesus Christ. That's why you must be very careful what you are doing. People are so wicked and wickedly taking advantage of others because they have a position of taking advantage. Let them be disgraced and be confounded permanently in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. God is so good. I'm telling you that God is good. When the enemy is planning doing wicked things against you, wait. When judgment of God will fall upon the person will not escape. Even if he do what? Because God is against the wicked. The principle of God is watching the wicked. When the wicked does not return and plan evil and wicked, they will not go free. Look at that in Psalms 35 verse 8. Psalms 35 verse 8. The Bible says, let destruction come upon him at unawares, and let his net that he had hidden catch himself unto that very destruction. Let him fall. The wicked, they know, they take advantage. They take advantage of others. They manipulate others and they abuse them and take advantage because they cannot help themselves. When you take advantage of the people, You take advantage of people abusing them, that because they are not able to help themselves, or you are rich, so you are taking advantage. You rob them, you lie on them, you cheat them, you think you will go free. The Lord Almighty will bring the very destruction, the method you are using to catch you, and you will never be escaped in Jesus' name. You will never escape. When the hook of God will come and catch you, you will never escape. Nobody will deliver you. That is what the Bible, the very destruction you are using to catch people, you are using to track people, it will catch you. I know a man, he was working, he was a personnel in the ministry, he was a personnel manager in post office in Kenya. So this man, he was hiring people, and people were bribing him a lot of money, up to $3,000, so much money. And they did that for so many, but he was giving people jobs. Now there was and then he reached a point where now he's lying. He's eating money because they obviously noticed that he's taking a lot of money from people. So they demote him, and people they didn't know. And then one time he went to the woman, a poor woman. The woman did not have anything. This man told him that, give me money, I will get your son a job. Then this woman said, where can I get the money? The woman went and looked for the money, went and look, but he didn't get the money. So he went and asked the boy who was going to get the job to go and work as somebody who's watching the cows of a rich man, so that he can get money to pay that man. Then when the man went there, this boy, when he went to look for the car to take care of the shepherd, to be a shepherd of a man, a rich man, then this man was asking, I know you finished the school, you have a certificate. Why do you want this job? He said, I was told to give money to the person so that I can get the job in post office. Now this manager, the rich man told this boy, are you sure this man is going to give you a job? The man said, yes, he has been employed so many people. Now, he said, he told my mother that if I gave him so much money, like 100, it was not much, but about $100, he would give me a job. Then the man said, only $100? Yes, I'm going to give you the dollars. Don't pay, don't come to work for me. That is what God will pay me. So this man, at this point, went and gave the man the post office man the $100, and then he told the man, go come tomorrow for interview. When he went there, the man was fired. The man was not there. Then he asked the people, where is so and so? He was told the so and so was fired yesterday. Yeah, and he said, what about the job that I was hired? The man said, there was no job, you were not hired. In fact, that is why he was fired, because he has been stealing from people. You see the destruction this man, the man suffered so much. Honestly speaking, this man, when I had my school, he came to look for a job in my place of work, the place where that he wants to come and even clean the classroom, a personal manager. He was miserable. Because all the money used to collect from people, he was eating in the bar, he used, misused, he squandered them. And because he robbed a lot of money, a lot of people from money. So the destruction that he was using, it fall upon the person. And this person become miserable. I don't know if he's alive or dead. All his property started selling one by one. All the things that he bought from the money was corrupting. He was getting from those people. He started selling them. He changed. He was big. Now he became so small. He sell everything that he had, even his own house, because he can't live without money. Yeah, you know the destruction that God will bring upon the wicked. The principle of God is watching wicked. The principle that God would apply, he would come against them and destroy them according to his word. The Bible says heaven and earth will pass, but the word of God will never fail. Heaven and earth will pass, but the word of God will never fail. Whether you believe or not, the principle of God remains permanent. That's why you see criminals, they don't care. they will go for it and damage people and do whatever they want. But when they are caught, that's the end of them. They will never escape. Have you seen a criminal being free? A criminal from here on earth to the heaven, they will never be free. Because they are terrorists. And this is the word of God. The Bible has declared a war against, the principle of God has declared a war against the wicked. Wicked, they are wickedly wicked. The Bible says, the wicked says, I will destroy them by my own hand. That is what the wicked says. But the principle of God, it says, yes, you plan that, but I will destroy you, I, God. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs 26, verse 27. Proverbs 26, verse 27. The Bible says, whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. Send back to the sender. That is the Bible. That is the word of God. It is not the Christian who wrote this word. It is not overcomers, deliverance, and healing ministry wrote this word. The Bible says, whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. So every corrupt person, every wicked person that plans wickedly, they dig for you to enter, they will enter in their own. Everybody planning evil against you, that very evil, they will enter in. They will dig a dig to enter in. The very dig, they will enter themselves. They will roll a stone for you, the stone to roll on you, but the stone will return and fall upon them. Everything they are doing, as a woman of God or a man of God, don't worry. They will never go free. That very thing, it will come and cover them. Hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. That is spiritual warfare prayer. That is how it works. People are so wicked and wickedly, and God is against them. God is talking against wicked people. The principle of God, it is clear, and it works very well against the wicked. The wicked can terrorize people all over. They are so powerful. They have powerful. They molested people. They do whatever they want. A manager, a man, in his own office, decide to abuse women. He doesn't respect any woman in that office because he's a boss. But God is watching him. The time comes when God will bring him down, felt so bad. That person will be finished and will be wiped completely. He will not be a person anymore. That's why I like this country. When this country catch you, that's the end of your life. They will never forgive you. Even if you do what? You will go to prison and pay for it. That is what God do. God will take his action. You might not have money to pay the lawyer. You might not have anything because you have been wiped off. But the Almighty God will fight for you. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Let's look in the book of Jeremiah 4, verse 4 to 5. Nehemiah. 4, verse 4 to 5. The Bible says, hear, O our God, for we are despised, and turn their reproach upon their own head, and give them a blade in the land of captivity, and cover not their iniquity, and let not their sin be brought out from before thee, for they have provoked thee to anger before the builders. Here is the man of God, Nehemiah. Nehemiah is praying like this. Hear, O our God, for we are despised. People have disrespected you. People have despised you. People have mocked you. They challenge your God. They test your God. They mock you. And the Bible says, and turn their reproach upon their own head. Turn their reproach upon their own head. Turn their miserable upon their own head. When people mock you, laugh at you, despise you, plan mischief against you, the very mischief, the very despite, the Lord Almighty will turn upon their head, and they will be found guilty. Their sins will not be forgiven. That is what the Psalms 109 says. That when they are charged, let them be found guilty and be charged because of the wicked they do to against the people. When they are taken to court, let them be found guilty and be charged and be punished by the law and by God himself in Jesus' name. All these powers of wicked, they shall be put a full stop. In the mighty name of Jesus, I'm going to pray. By the power in the blood of Jesus, I pray illegal power of darkness showing up where your children, where the children of God are gathered. I pray that, let me say this again. It is illegal for the powers of darkness to show up where children of the living God are gathered. Therefore, I destroy all demon associated of demons in the area right now in Jesus' name. I pray that every legal rights that the enemy is claiming or the enemy knows about you, that is following you to abuse you, to use against you, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Every illegal right of the enemy that is using against you, conscious or unconscious, let them be cut off completely according to the word of God in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty will come against every illegal enemy is using against you. Every legal, whether unconscious or conscious, against you and your family, let it be cut off completely in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I pray that God Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ, every satanic gathering against your life, every satanic grouping that they plan how to come and rob you, how to come and con you, how to come and destroy you, let the Almighty God cut them into pieces in Jesus' name. I destroy that grouping. I destroy that gathered. I destroy them. Let them be scattered. They will come in one way, but they will fly in seven ways. That's what the Bible says. The principle of God in the book of Deuteronomy, the Bible says that your enemy will come in one way, but they will fly in seven ways. By the power in the blood of Jesus, let every enemy that are gang together against you, let them flee seven ways in Jesus' name, according to the word of God. My God and my Father, I pray according to your word, God, that when the enemy gathered against you, against your family, against your children, to rob you, to deceive you, let them be flying seven ways. Let them be lost their direction and fly in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, arise in your power. Wage war against wicked. Wage war against wicked and deceived people in the name of Jesus. Wage war against deceived people in the mighty name of Jesus. I am praying this. I feel very strongly that people, corrupt people, people who are deceiving others, this week, this time, they will not go free. You will hear many, many people will be put in jail, and some of them will be destroyed. And physically, anyone, anywhere in the world who will hear these videos, everyone who is corrupt, that bribing, that deceiving people that you are going to help them and you are not, the Lord Almighty will come against them. They will be disgraced and exposed and be destroyed from this earth forever in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I pray that God, people are suffering, especially pension office in some places, even in the hospital. The doctor cannot see you, a government officer, or a government doctor. You have to bribe them. You have to give them money to see a patient. And it's paid. If you have a case in police, the police cannot come unless you bribe them. Father, in the name of Jesus, those are corrupt. Those are very highly corrupt. Father God, it is wicked. I pray that God Almighty destroy them and remove them from that position. Remove every corrupt person, every wicked and evil person. Father, I prophesy against them. We've been given authority against the wicked, against evil, to prophesy against them. They have been disturbing people so much. They have made people suffer so much. They are miserable. Those wicked, they make people to suffer so much. They make people suffer. These wicked people, they make people to suffer. You can go to the office 100 times. The person is not there. The person is changing every time you go there. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we have to put a stop to the enemies. In the mighty name of Jesus, the enemies that has gathered together to lie, to cheat you, to disgrace you, let themselves be disgraced and exposed in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, I want to thank you. God Almighty, I command even all crocodiles. I command you to vomit everything you have swallowed up in the life of this person in Jesus' name. You know some wicked, they use witchcraft power so that they spell on people, and people, they become so blind, they don't see, they don't know. When they ask money, you just give them. When they ask pride, they use very highly power of darkness to get some money from people. Falsely. Father, in the name of Jesus, your principle does not change. They would use, I've said, everything they are doing, it will return to their own head. Therefore, I prophesy right now, by the power and the blood of Jesus, every corrupt person, every evil person that is bribing, let them be exposed and disgraced in Jesus' name. Let them be caught in the name of Jesus. Release the angels of heaven and arrest them. All what they have been eating, all what they have been taking from people, let them start vomiting them. Vomit them, everyone, in Jesus' name. Yes, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, keep giving me more hearts. I thank God that God is able. God, our God, is able in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Oh, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that show the enemy where has kept your blessings. In the name of Jesus, let God show you where the enemy has kept your blessings. Your presence that has been kept by the enemy, let God Almighty show you, and let the enemy vomit it, and let the enemy remove it in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, arise and chase away every dog pursuing you. Maybe you see the dogs pursuing you at night, pursuing you at the dreams, even as dogs beating, biting you, or peck on you. Let those dogs be put to stop in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Every power of darkness transacting business underneath great water, I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. You know there is business. They are operating under the water. When this the spirit of water, I may not talk to them so much because you don't understand this. They are a witchcraft, they are enemies using the power of water to translate your business or your jobs. When they operate in the water, they will tie you down, and they will say, as the water goes, because the water does not turn back, as that's how you get your money goes like that water. They program wicked and evil, and then you work so hard because the enemy has programmed something and thrown the water, and then it runs the way the water runs. Therefore, I am commanding them, those wicked power, to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I bind them, I render them powerless in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God, I want to thank you, my God. I want to bless your name, God. I thank you, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus. Let the principle of God against the wicked fall upon every wicked, fall upon every evil, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God. Jesus Christ, you came to destroy the works of the devil. Therefore, destroy every wicked personality, every evil that is done in the dark world, in the kingdom of darkness, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every kingdom of darkness that is operating against any child of God, anyone, I destroy them, I bind them, I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that God, my God, deliver your people from the hands of the enemy. Deliver your people from the wicked. Deliver your people from evil personality. Deliver your people from every manipulation people. Deliver your people from spells and chanters in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that let your blessings fall upon your people, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. I pray, let them recover what they have lost. Let them recover what the enemy has taken from them, in the name of Jesus. Let them recover everything, every tears, every cry they have been crying, God. Lord, I pray, wipe them, wipe their tears, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Release the Holy Spirit to comfort them, because your word says the Holy Spirit will comfort them, will help them, will protect them. Let the Holy Spirit speak to them and comfort them, all those who are going through pains because of what the wicked has done to their life. My God and my Father, I pray that God heal them. Lord, heal them. Heal them, my Father. Heal their souls, God. Souls who have been wounded so hard. I pray that God, my Father, heal them, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. I plead the blood of Jesus over you and your family right now, in the name of Jesus. That sickness that is tormenting you, I command them to be destroyed and to be vanished in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I destroy every works of the devil. I destroy every works of the enemy by the power in the blood of Jesus. I pray that God Almighty will answer you by fire. By fire, in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. I thank you, Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. See you tomorrow, 8 o'clock. Tomorrow, 8 o'clock a.m. See you. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. You can also call us. Our number, hallelujah, praise the name of Jesus. We have our numbers, cell phone and landline and free number. So you can call us on our cell phone number, 647-608-5207. That is our cell phone number. And the landline number is 905-487-7196. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a great day. See you tomorrow. And this is your host.